Good afternoon and welcome to our 12:05 Mass here at the Church of St. Francis Xavier. We begin our prayer as always in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May our God be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, as we prepare to celebrate our Eucharist this afternoon, we call to mind God's great gifts in our lives and our response. And we begin our prayer by asking for strength, healing, and forgiveness. We say simply, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us all, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life without end.
Amen.
And so we pray. O God, hope and light of the sincere, we humbly entreat you to dispose our hearts to offer you worthy prayer, and ever to extol you by dutiful proclamation of your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. A Pharisee in the Sanhedrin named Gamaliel, teacher of the law, respected by all the people, stood up, ordered the apostles to be put outside for a short time, and said to the Sanhedrin, "Fellow children of Israel, be careful what you are about to do to these men. Some time ago, Thutis appeared, claiming to be someone important, and about 400 men joined him, but he was killed. And all those who were loyal to him were disbanded, came to nothing. After him came Judas the Galilean at the time of the census. He also drew people after him, but he too perished, and all who were loyal to him were scattered. So now I tell you, have nothing to do with these men, and let them go. For if this endeavor or this activity is of human origin, it will destroy itself. But if it comes from God, you will not be able to destroy them. You may even find yourselves fighting against God." They were persuaded by him. After recalling the apostles, they had them flogged, ordered them to stop speaking in the name of Jesus, and dismissed them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name. And all day long, both at the temple and in their homes, they did not stop teaching and proclaiming the Christ, Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord. One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid? One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord. One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple. One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord. I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord. One thing I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him, because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Peter, "Where can I buy food enough for them to eat?" He said this to put them to the test, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There's a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place. So the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves and gave thanks and distributed them to those who were reclining, so that, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had their fill, he said to the disciples, "Gather the fragments left over, so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments of the 5 barley loaves that had been more than they could eat. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who was to come into the world." Since Jesus knew that they were going to come and carry him off to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Scriptures today once again challenge us on what are our perceptions. What do we see and what are we looking for in a lot of different ways? From starting with the Acts of the Apostles, and we have the disciples, of course, have been preaching. They were scolded and told not to do it. Then they went and did it again. They came back. So they're getting their second hearing, and they could be up for some serious jail time in the context of the Jewish law. And then this teacher, Gamaliel, gets up and speaks. He's a Pharisee. And the Pharisees believed in the resurrection. And so they were pretty sympathetic to a lot of the teaching about that these disciples of Jesus were going, were saying. And so he offers this very practical piece of wisdom. Don't fight against them. If it's a human cause, it will run its course. If it's divine, you'll find yourself fighting against God. I think sometimes there are days when we're finding ourselves at least arguing with God in this context of our quarantine, of our sheltering in place. And all. We're arguing with a lot of things that we feel grouchy about. But it's a question of perception. Gamaliel is saying, we don't know whether this is from God or not. Let it run its course. So he's going to be respectful of this movement and let it show itself. But on the other hand, the disciples, the very disciples who ran when Jesus was arrested, the very disciples who hid when Jesus was executed, the very disciples who were in hiding after the resurrection, they say, they give thanks because they were counted worthy for humiliation because of the word. Their lives are so changed. Their attitude is so changed. They just cannot help preaching about the risen Lord. How are our attitudes changed? How does our faith in the Lord, the risen Lord Jesus, change us? During the course of our Easter season, we're going to hear a lot from the Gospel of John. We're only in the 6th chapter, and we have John's version of the multiplication of the loaves and the fishes. It's the scriptures scholars point out to us that in the other, the synoptic John Gospels, this thing takes place at the end of the day. It's nearly night, and send them away to get some food. This is sort of in the middle of the day. People find probably because they've seen signs in the curing, the healing that Jesus has done. They've seen signs.
us gather up our prayers before our God. We pray first for Pope Francis and for the Church. The Church will continue to be a beacon of hope and light in this time of darkness and despair. So for the Church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for peace because war has not stopped with this pandemic. We pray for the victims of war and violence, the refugees, those fleeing for their safety. For them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our leaders, that they will guide us prudently and safely through this time of crisis. For our leaders, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all those on the front lines, first responders, the healthcare workers, the ordinary clerks in the store, the people delivering groceries, all the people who sustain us in this time of trouble. Who are there for us. In gratitude for their service, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, of course, for the victims of the virus, those who are struggling with illness, and those who are listed in our parish listing today, but also those who have succumbed to the virus, that they be granted God's peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I just heard today of a Jesuit a few years ahead of us, Crisco, who died and succumbed to the virus just yesterday. So for Michael and for his family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of our dead, and especially we pray today and remember Leona Lepisco, for whom we offer this mass. For them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, you are the source of our hope. Hear your children's prayers offered today as always, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bless you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread and wine to offer, which earth is given in human hands and made, that it become for us our spiritual food and drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Let us pray that his sisters and brothers pray that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands to the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. It is our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising the life, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land and every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your praise as they say, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to them and said, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving you thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness.
forgiveness of the sin of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
You are the Savior of the world.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis and Timothy and all those who serve your people. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. The with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray then for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. Peace is a gift I want for each of you. So look not upon our sins and negligences, but upon the faith of your church. And graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our God be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another safely. Sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the one who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Take a moment for a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally. Come at me spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already here, and unite myself wholly to you, never permitted to be separated from you. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharist is ended. Let us walk in the light of God's love.
Thanks be to God.
Stay safe.